lot about that lately. If I ask any one of you brothers and sisters, is Maria the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I already answered, but it's okay. Is she was a slave lady or she was one of the mothers of the believers? What's your answer? Somebody asking you that question.
Mothers of the believers.
Maria, she was one of, actually, Rasulullah ﷺ, he had 12 wives, right? But most of the scholars of Seerah or Mudawwineen, those who wrote the Seerah and the Tafsir and whatever, they considered her a slave lady. You know, Maria, the Coptic Maria. Do you know what I'm talking about? The Egyptian Maria, she was the Coptic Messiah, yes. If she was wife, one of the wives of the Prophet, or she was just a slave lady? What's your answer?
She was the wife of the Prophet.
Okay.
Sharia.
Huh?
Sharia.
I'm asking her a question, not Sharia, don't explain. If she was a wife or not? لا ما تشرحش. شرح أنا أشرحه. I'm the one who can explain this. But your answer is yes or no? Yes, she was his wife. Okay. But Abu Fras. Sheikh Al-Albani ضعف هذا الحديث. Sheikh Al-Albani is weak hadith. Okay. But the point here is, let us discuss it more, open the subject. If you ask any sheikh, especially those who are in Arabia, they never consider Maria, radiallahu anha, may Allah be pleased with her, they never considered her a wife of the Prophet. They said Maria al-Mahdiya, يعني she was a slave lady. Maria al-Mahdiya, this is what they say. Let's go back to Maria. Maria, who is Maria? Mary or Maria? She was, yes, a slave lady, but in reality she was not a slave. She was one of the high position women from the Coptics and the al-Muqawqis. When they used to attack each other, they took her as a slave. But she was, in reality, she was not a slave. She was a very noble lady. Somehow she came to al-Muqawqis, the leader of Egypt, during the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, with her sister, Sirin. And they were in the slavery because that war and the attack, it was during that time. When Rasulullah ﷺ sent a message to al-Muqawqis, who was a Coptic of Egypt, Subhanallah, al-Muqawqis, he sent him back as a gift, Maria, her sister Sirin, four horses, Egyptian horses, Arabian horses, and a doctor, Egyptian doctor. He returned the doctor, and he accepted the horses and the Maria and Sirin. Maria, she became the wife of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they can give you some proofs. And Sirin, her sister, Hassan ibn Thabit, the poet of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he married her sister, Sirin. Maria, when she came, that Sahabi, when they came from Egypt, when he came with them, he was talking about Islam and the beauty of Islam to them in the way when they came from Egypt to Medina. Before they reached Medina, Sirin and Maria, they became Muslims. They said the Shahada. Before even they reached Medina, subhanAllah. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married her, and her dowry was her freedom. She became free. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how these scholars, they consider Maria one of the slaves while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to free the slaves. He freed 63 slaves, men and women, during his life sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 63 like his age sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there is an authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he died, he did not leave money behind him or a slave lady or a slave woman. ما ترك درهما ولا عبدا ولا أمة. This authentic حديث in Sahih Bukhari. Yes. Even yes, of course, his son Ibrahim, and Ibrahim the son of Mariyah, he died when he was 16 months. But the point here is, if al-Bukhari, in his Sahih, said, Rasulullah, when he died, he did not leave behind him money, no money, or a slave lady or a slave woman, how Mariyah she was a slave. That's number one. Number two, Rasulullah ﷺ, most of his day, he used to stay in with Mary. He used to love her so much. Even Aisha radiallahu anha, she became so jealous. Yeah, and two women, Aisha, she was so jealous of them. Mariyah and Khadija. Yes, Mariyah, Rasulullah ﷺ, he used to spend all of his time during the day and night with her. And the Aisha, she get jealous. And even the mothers of the believers, they get jealous too. طبعاً of course, especially حفصة and سورة التحريم I read it today. يا أيها النبي لما تحرم ما أحل الله لك تبتغي مرضات أزواجك. Why this تحريم comes? Some of the مفسرين they said رسول الله was sleeping with Maria in the house of حفصة. And حفصة she said in my bed يا رسول الله, and she get jealous of her because she was so beautiful. Maria كانت دعجة بيضاء. And she was so beautiful. It is not because of her beauty, Rasulullah used to love her. Because she was a really mu'mina too, subhanAllah. So what happened is, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took her away from the mothers of the believers. First of all, because they get jealous of her. And she's not from Arabia, land of Arabia. Maybe somebody is Sheikh, going to say, and why? Yes, she was not from the land of Arabia. They're going to treat her different. فبنى لها دويرة في عوالي المدينة. And he built up for her a small house in the far away in في عوالي المدينة. What is عوالي المدينة? What is the palm trees? المدينة was full of palm trees. What is the palm trees? What is the سبحان الله water and all of that? Why? Etiquette. The etiquette of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. She came from Egypt. Egypt is green. You know, see the Nile River there and the green stuff. But عوالي المدينة, that spot where Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم built a house for Maria, this out of his etiquette, gentleness, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Most of that area was desert, around that is desert. يعني if you consider during that time, desert comparing to عوالي المدينة, green palm trees, and they said Maria, you live there, you come from Egypt, from the green area, water and stuff. No, let's be put you something similar. This out of his gentleness, صلى الله عليه وسلم. And she came with a slave man from her relatives. His name was Ma'bur. That Ma'bur, he used to serve Maria. And the Sahaba, when they saw the love of Rasulullah to Maria, they said, you don't do anything. Even she did not serve herself. How she can be a slave while she has a servant? Ma'bur, that guy, he used to serve her. He came with her from Egypt. SubhanAllah, how she was a slave. She did not even serve Rasulullah. She did not serve herself. Somebody used to serve her. She never served any one of the mothers of the believers. And she had her own house. How she can be a slave? Plus, like what Abu Faras said, she get Ibrahim. She get him a son. You know, even they said it's a weak hadith, Sheikh al-Albani, but the fuqaha and the scholar of the fiqh, they said, this is what they said. If she was a slave and she get a boy to her master, she became free because of that. How these sheikhs, when I hear them, they said, Maria, the slave of Rasulullah. She was not a slave of Rasulullah. She was the wife of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and you have to taradda anha. You have to say, رضي الله عنها, may Allah be pleased with her. And she was one of the mothers of the believers. Not because I'm Egyptian, I'm saying that. If we talk about Maria, forget Maria. What about Hajar? Some people nowadays, they said Hajar, she was a slave of Sarah. Why you put them down? Why? Because they are Egyptian? Actually, yes. Yes. If you read the history, the people of Arabia, those who used to read the seerahs and the Buddha, the seerahs and tadwin the seerah and tadwin the history, these people, they used to put the superiority for Arab people. Above Turkish, above Egyptian, above Shawam, those who are in Sham area, Palestine or Syria, or they used to put the superiority of Arab above all of these, the same Na'rat al-Arabiyya, that discrimination, what they call it tribalism. You know, yes, it was. Those who used to put the seerah, and they used to write the seerah and tadwin al-seerah or whatever, you know. Now, this is fact. When we read, we find out this. That's why we take it from these people before 1,000 years, almost 1,000 years, these people, those who wrote the seerah, we take it as is from them. Mariyah, she was a slave. Oh, okay. This is demographia or whatever they used to think. But we have to change our mind. There is no dalil from the Quran or the Sunnah, and this is the main thing for me, saying Maria, she was a slave lady. Yes, she was in the beginning. What about Safiya? Bint Huwayy ibn al-Akhtar. Huh? She was a slave lady too. But Rasulullah, he freed her and he married her. But they say Safiya because she's Jewish. They cannot say anything about her. But yes, be careful. خلي بالك. Maria, subhanAllah, Hajar, she was Egyptian also. They said the slave and she was the servant of Sarah. Allah. The same Hajar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her the water of Zamzam and she's making between Safa and Al-Marwa. We are imitating her until the day of judgment in Hajj. They said she was a slave too. Allah. And Maria, she was a slave too. What about Safiya? May Allah be pleased with them all. But from all of these shawahid, there are too many things really. Even some of these people, they attack Maria and they said she did adultery, like exactly the same like Aisha radiallahu anha in Medina when they said Aisha hadith al-ifk in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala barra'a Maria. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told Rasulullah, Maria, she's free from that kind of crime, and she was not a doctor lady or something, like she did not make it. How? Ma'bur, that servant, he was relative to Maria. Rasulullah appointed him to serve her. That man, he used to go and out and go in to her too much to serve her. For what they said, Munafiqeen, they said, that baby or that ghulam, she became pregnant of Ibrahim, the son of Rasulullah. This is not the son of Prophet Muhammad. This is the son of Ma'bur, her servant. Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, and another narration said Umar ibn Khattab, he took, both of them, they took the sword to kill Ma'bur, that servant. And he was taking shower when they found him in the area. He was taking shower. And what happened, they found nothing between his legs. Kana majburan. He has no umbuli. Nothing at all. Kana majbur. In Arabic, they call kana majburan. That guy, they did not find anything. Sayyidina Umar came back and said, Ya Rasulallah, the man has nothing between his legs. Yes, Allah created him like this, majbur. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Atani Jibreel. Jibreel just came to me from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said, your wife, Maria, Mary, she has a boy in her. She's pregnant with a boy and name him Ibrahim. Allah, the one who names Ibrahim, the son of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Name him Ibrahim, and he is your son, and I will give you a nickname. You are the father of Ibrahim. Anta Abu Ibrahim. Who said that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he freed that beautiful and noble lady, Maria radiallahu anha, from this shameful act. Like what exactly said about our mother, Aisha radiallahu anha, in Surah An-Nur, Hadith al-Ifk. When we hear about Maria, we have to say, radiallahu anha, she's one of the mothers of the believers. She was one of the wives of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hada wallahu a'lam. Hey, Brother Rafiq.
What you said this morning, really, it should be a lesson for us Muslims. Also, I noticed when people want to talk about Bilal, they'll say, oh, look at the slave that is, you know, like he was put in a higher rank. The Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to prove to us that, you know, all these slavery things are not accepted in Islam.
Exactly.
And we should not continue to write history like, oh, okay,
blindly, yes.
The slave,
yes,
married by Prophet Ibrahim or Maria, the slave married by is the wife of the prophet.
Yes, sir. This is discrimination to the mothers of the believers. And like what we said, there is no book at all was talking about the slavery or anything except the Quran al-Kareem. Ya subhanallah. Ya jamaat al-khair, how Islam, how we still talking about one of the mothers of the believers? She's a slave. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the ransom or the kafara or the expiation or whatever. You know, when you make a sin, to free a slave. And the Rasulullah said, look how Abu Bakr said, how many? Subhanallah. Umar ibn al-Khattab, he used to say, our master, Abu Bakr, he freed our master, Bilal. Umar said that. فَجَمَعَةِ الْخَيْرِ إِحْنَا really we have to change our mind. There is no slavery, there is no discrimination in Islam. There is nothing. All we are all brothers, black or white or whatever. Subhanallah, Allah is not looking at your skin or your height or your... This is discrimination, this is tribalism. And this is not in Islam at all. Especially with somebody like Maria radiallahu anha, or Hajar radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen Maria radiallahu anha, or Hajar, the wife of Prophet Ibrahim عليه وعلى نبينا أفضل الصلاة والسلام. ربنا تقبل منا فإنك أنت السميع العليم، واغفر لنا فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم، تب علينا يا مولانا فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا اغفر لنا واسترنا واجبرنا وارحمنا واهدنا يا رب العالمين. نسألك خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير الرزق وخير العلم. اللهم يا رب ثقل موازيننا وحقق إيماننا وارفع درجتنا. نسألك العلو من الجنة والنجاة من النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك خير هذا اليوم وخير ما فيه وخير ما بعده، ونعوذ بك من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما فيه وشر ما بعده يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.